I think that context is really important, right? The evolution from Orion to this halfway point. But my question to start is, who is this targeted at, right? You have generations of prior generation Meta Ray-Ban wearers. Or is this a new entry, people starting from scratch?
I think it'll probably be some combination of both. So just because we're talking about it here, these are the Meta Ray-Ban displays. Right. You can see we've worked with Ray-Ban to get them into the form factor that people are comfortable wearing. This is the most worn design for a pair of sunglasses or glasses. And so we're starting with something. We didn't want to put something onto the market that was clunky. We're starting with something that's really, really nice. And I'll also just mention there's a waveguide in here.
Okay, which a waveguide being?
Basically, it's light that's being projected through a series of mirrors into a small display that appears just below your right eye, and you can actually change where that is.
It's $800, right?
That's right.
But the emphasis over and over again is like, this is a consumer product.
Yes.
It's not for engineers.
That's right.
What is the one killer feature in it then that you think is going to appeal?
Messaging.
Just messaging.
Well,
so
that's,
Mark Zuckerberg was talking about, that's how he uses it. Yeah.
Yeah, messaging I'd say is going to be the most useful to start. It comes with this wristband, which is an EMG wristband. You wear it around your wrist. It detects very subtle muscular and nervous system sort of activity so that you can just use a tiny gesture with your fingertips to control essentially a cursor
Yes.
that controls the display. So we've worked to get into something that means that you can use a display in glasses without needing to wave your hands around in the world or carry around a mouse or something.
And this is why evolution is important. The neural band is directly from the Orion project.
That's
I remember experimenting with the technology 1 year ago.
So the R&D here is you have the North Star, which you've seen, which is Orion, like you said, and then you're also working forwards from what we know people are comfortable wearing, which is the Ray-Bans. I think we're going to see early adopters pick it up, to your question.
Yes.
I think we're going to see enthusiasts. Like you were mentioning to me before, you wear the Meta Ray-Bans a fair amount.
Ah, but I wear them when I'm driving.
Yeah, well, that's a thing.
Because the display in the Ray-Ban display,
right.
Obviously, if you're driving, not the best use case.
Yeah, not intended for driving.
Last night, you did live demos.
Uh-huh.
Some of them didn't go very well, but you're getting a lot of credit for doing live demos. Mm-hmm. Just very simply and for transparency, what did go wrong in those demos?
I haven't looked into them. I believe it was the Wi-Fi. But we're trying to have these events where we're not canning them. We know people don't want something that's canned. So we're erring on the side of trying to do it live.
I've got a question from our audience.
Yep.
Ray-Ban display, will it be available for prescription lenses?
Yes.
And why was that important? This is a question that's come up a lot with Ray-Bans.
Well, just we know around 1 to 2 billion people on Earth wear glasses. A bunch of them are wearing them as sunglasses, and then a whole bunch of folks are wearing them with prescriptions.
Chris, where are these going to be manufactured?
I'm not 100% sure.
Your chief product officer, and you don't know where?
Yeah, I think it's in a handful of places. The parts are assembled in a bunch of different places.
Not China? Or is there a sensitivity around supply chain hardware in China?
I believe there's some work being done in China, but I'm not 100% sure.
What I'm always trying to understand with Meta is where the company stands today. At times, and presently, I think about the family of apps. You ran Facebook. Those people that are religious users of Facebook or WhatsApp, what is their relationship to this new generation of hardware?
So you'll be able to use WhatsApp on the device. We're trying to make sure that we're starting with communication, which is where the company comes from, making sure those products work well on the device. You're also able to view Instagram Reels, which we know people love. We're trying to just get a handful of first-party experiences right, and then eventually we'll be able to open that up.
Mark was talking about this as the vehicle for super intelligence, but you also have a background in software, so this is the interface. This is how I interact with it. But what other AI features can we expect to come through this mechanism and the family of apps as well?
We mentioned yesterday translation, live translation.
Yes.
Including the ability to caption somebody you're speaking to in a different language. We also mentioned the ability to focus a conversation. We're calling it conversation focus. So if you're in a crowded room, if you're at a party, if you're at a concert, you're able to focus in on the person who's speaking to you and get a clearer audio of that. And so all of those things involve applications of AI to bring these things to life in ways that are practical.
I got a lot of questions from Meta users and the audience about what the developer community needs to know, but also your role in AI at Meta. What is it that you are focused on right now? Because we've reported a lot on the team changes, the super intelligence team. From a product perspective, I think people really want to understand, like, what is your focus?
Yeah.
And where are you going to bring more functionality to that?
Well, so there's the wearables, but there's also creative tools. So the ways that people are creating video, creating content, making that's really, really easy. AI is going to make it a lot easier for folks to do that. And a huge part of what Facebook and Instagram are is just, you know, viewing the content that we create for each other. So that's where we're expecting to land a lot of the newest technology.